A blow to Narius Moloto's faction, not recognized by the IEC, its options are limited. In recent years, leadership squabbles saw the formation of two factions, one loyal to Nyonzo and the other to Moloto. The battles played in the courts, further eroding the PAC's support base. It has one seat in parliament.
The Electoral Commission is an apolitical body, and we do not wish to participate in the internal affairs of political parties, including the determination of who the authentic leadership is. But in this case, there's been a long, protracted history of contestation of the true and authentic leadership of the PAC. So the decision that the Commission has taken arises out of three court judgments that has been placed at us at our disposal in the recent past.
But Moloto accuses the IEC of interfering in internal PAC politics.
Now, all the time they were telling us that they are not competent. We must go to the court of law where the dispute is alleged. This time around, we don't know where such a law has been amended to give the IEC the authority to decide. It's not up to them to decide who's the legitimate leadership of the PAC. That's nonsense. That's totally unacceptable.
The IEC recognized group is unfazed.
With regard to the legal threat from Narius, it's really a lame threat. Because if he wanted to do that, he should have appealed the judgments as they stand now. He should have gone to SCA in Cape Town, in Bloemfontein. He has not done so. He should have gone to Pretoria High Court. He has not done so. For him to say that now, for us, it's a lame threat, and we'll not even dignify that.
Bowe says they are now focused on the upcoming strategy planning conference. Nhlanhla Khatlani, SABC News, Johannesburg.